marathon. Your thoughts on just how this one played out throughout the 53 minutes?
We just didn't do a well enough job just closing this down tonight.
Your thoughts on getting 23 pointers to drop as a team, but having some free throws and some kind of chip shots at the rim roll out for you?
Yeah, it sucks. Have plays at the rim and then just not having a strong enough, focus at the free throw line. It is what it is, part of the game. We did more than enough to win tonight, especially, again, being up, closing the game out, letting it slip away.
Who flipped for you all at the start of that fourth quarter? I think you had like a 10-0 burst to really get back into it.
We had to make a push. It's down 10, we got to make a push. That's the only thing that was like the mindset for the team, flying back into the game.
Well, you obviously missed a big free throw late. Does that one haunt you a little bit? Do you process it and kind of move on? How do you deal with one like that?
Then again, we were still up to finish the game off. We probably went by one had to make that, but we should close this one out.
Paul, what's your mindset going into this last little stretch of the season?
Win everyone. Take one game at a time. Try to win everyone.
Paul, Carmelo kind of made the decision, apparently, to tell Billy to roll with Jeremy down the stretch. Did that surprise you to not have Carmelo out on the floor with you down the stretch in regulation?
Mel's a veteran guy. For whatever reason, he felt JG was the best fit for the unit to close the game out. He made his impact for us still down the stretch with big three and OT. So, it's just Melo, making a team decision.
There have been a lot of things written and said about Carmelo through his career. One of the things a lot of people don't talk about maybe is an unselfish thing like that. What do you think it says, though, that Melo would look at the fact that Jeremy's playing so well and saying, let him roll out?
Yeah, you're talking about a guy that played extremely well himself, shot the ball at a really high level and was, instant bucket, just timely baskets, big shots, big threes, and for him to let JG, can't continue on with the group out there, it's definitely says a lot about who Melo is and, his character.
How did you think Jeremy performed in those quarter minutes?
Well, he performed well. He made a big three in the corner. I found him late. Thought we had a layup there. I knew Plumlee was going to make a play at the basket. I told him maybe a pump fake, get him in there, try to get that foul. That play just haunts me in general. I had Melo open on the perimeter as well as he shot it. I was confident he would have made that one. I had faith in both of those guys. I thought Jeremy still played really, really great tonight for us.
That intentionally missed free throw at the very end, is that you improvising or is that a design play?
I talked with Melo and Steve-O. They said they was gonna go get it. I wanted to make it a free throw battle. And give ourselves a chance. Late, we had to make a three. But those guys said they was gonna go get it. Came out to be a good miss. We were just a little early.
The way y'all shot free throws this season, Paul, are y'all still confident going to the line late in games?
Yeah, absolutely.
What's your mindset there when you force that jump ball? Is there a little internal timer going for you about when to keep going for the steal and when to ultimately foul? Because it seemed like you got it right tonight.
We knew at that point, usually teams are on the defense. They just want to secure the ball and not really looking to make plays or, especially a young group. So we just wanted to kind of keep the pressure on them. If we were able to get a jump ball, we was going to go with it, but, obviously time started to take too much. We had to foul, but we was fortunate to get a trap and get a hand on the ball.